two House committees have formally recommended the filing of charges against PhilHealth officials in connection with the corruption issues hounding the agency. To give us details, Rhea Fernandez reports to us live from the Batasang Pambansa. Rhea, good afternoon. Who are these officials that have been included in the lawmakers' recommendation?
Charles Health Secretary Francisco Duque III, former PhilHealth Chief Ricardo Morales, and several other top ranking officials are found liable in the PhilHealth corruption mess. The House Committees on Public Accounts and Good Government recommended the filing of cases against these personalities based on their over 70-page committee report. The nature of charges will vary on members of the PhilHealth Board and the Executive Committee, according to Public Accounts Chairperson Mike Defensor. The lawmakers made this decision after rejecting Good Government Panel Chairperson Jonathan Alvarado's motion to absolve the Duque-chaired PhilHealth Board from the anomalies. His motion was initially focused on the issues surrounding PhilHealth's all-case rate system. Alvarado said he believes in the good intention of the policy set by the board, but he thinks the problem lies in the implementation. Hence, he proposed that the Execom should only be the ones to face raps. However, his colleagues begged to differ, as reflected on the results of their nominal voting. House lawmakers also noted abuses in the interim reimbursement mechanism, such as the huge cash advances and releases even to non-accredited and non-COVID facilities. They also pointed out the disadvantageous settlements with some hospitals, as well as the lack of payment system, among others. Here's what Public Accounts Chair Mike Defensor had to say about their decision.
Walang pinili o iniwasan ang pinagsamang komite sa mga opisyal mula sa loob ng PhilHealth at maging sa kataas-taas ng mga nanunungkulan sa ating pamahalaan.
Charles, the House panels also sought in their committee report the removal of mandatory PhilHealth contributions of the OFWs as stated in the Universal Healthcare Law. They also sought the granting of emergency powers to President Duterte to overhaul the PhilHealth agency, as well as the inclusion of a special provision on the General Appropriations Bill to protect the national government's 71 billion peso contribution to PhilHealth for next year. Charles?
Thanks for that, Rhea. That was Rhea Fernandez reporting live from the Batasang Pambansa.